Hi, today we are going to be talking about email writing, the basics only. We know that email has become a very, very important part of our life since most of the time we are interacting and communicating detailed data or information on email, which either is done on the phone, but however a black and white document, it always helps, you know, to make people understand and of course to also document certain conversations that we've had. So let's talk about email. Today we are actually going to be talking about the relevance, the advantages and disadvantages. We are going to understand the format of an email. We are going to talk about composing an email as per standard template and five fundamental rules of email writing. Okay. So, what are the advantages? Firstly, it is speed. So, speed, we used to send letters, we used to send faxes, we used to send telegrams, etc. Right. But it does not beat the speed of an email. Email kuch hi seconds mein pahunch jata hai, theek hai, letters hafta do hafta, telegrams maybe a few days, right? But fax can also take a lot of time, provided you know if the connection is not correct, the paper is not there, so on and so forth. There can be its own glitches, and speed definitely cannot be beaten for that. It's inexpensive, no use of paper, no use of anything in specific except for the internet, and it goes off like in the speed like a fraction of a second. So therefore, it is extremely inexpensive. We are not using anything that is additional. Accessibility, you can read the emails at any point of time, you can access it over your phone, you can read the emails at any time, as in anywhere also. You might want to go back and look at the emails again. Aap ek hafta pehle jo email aaya tha, aap wo pad sakte, and you know, so it is really, really accessible at any point of time. Okay, convenience, again, you know, you don't have to specifically be at home. Like letter agar aata tha, to you have to make sure you're at home. Faxes, especially in office, but emails, you know, you can be at the other end of the world. You probably are not even at home. You're on a holiday or anything. That's the way to go. Environment friendly, no paper, only, you know, internet is all that you need, right? So definitely environment friendly, easy to manage and filter. So earlier jab koi letter aata tha ya koi document ya you know koi document, official document bhi agar aata tha, to hum usko file karte the, right? So you would find one file, you know, ek department ka. We used to put one file of one particular client. We would have one file of one particular project, okay? And then jab aapko kuch dhoondna hota tha, ek particular conversation, okay, we had to actually look through it. Shayad 6 mahine pehle ka kuch documentation ho ya koi letter aaya ho, or for that matter shayad 1 saal pehle ka aaya ho, right? You are trying to recollect the entire thing. It is a very, very tedious job. However, with an email, you know, you can put it in certain folders, or for that matter you can just search for the sender and everything is right there in a matter of seconds. Transmission is secure and reliable because obviously, you know, we have you know, our servers, we have our service providers that you know for sure that it is definitely going to reach. At times when we used to send letters, it used to get lost, it used to reach late. Information never used to reach on time, etc. But with email, definitely it does. When there are advantages, disadvantages bhi definitely honge. The disadvantages kya honge? Disadvantages, unintentionally, okay, tension or conflict ho jata hai. Unintentionally, in a sense, like aapne shayad choice of words aapne गलत किया हो, या ग्रामर आपका सही ना हो, या आपका पंक्चुएशन अगर सही नहीं था, ओके, यू डिड नॉट डू इट इंटेंशनली, दैट्स व्हाई वी आर सेइंग, यू नो दैट आप चाहते नहीं थे, बट मे बी आप जल्दी जल्दी में लिख रहे थे, या यू नो यू वर कॉट अप विद सर्टेन अदर काइंड ऑफ वर्क विथ इट ऑल्सो, सो यू रोट एन ई मेल So, but it did not give the right kind of a message to the reader or the recipient. Okay. So, it has created a tension and a conflict unnecessarily. Okay. It can be overused because, you know, for small little things we send out an email. Okay, aapka one liner jo conversation hai jo probably shayad ek phone call ke upar ho jata, but log email bhej dete hain, you know, ek particular email jo hai wo ek trail ho jata hai with just one liner each, fine. So it tends to get a little overused also. It can seriously drain, you know, a productive time of an employee, because drafting an email means black and white documentation of things. Okay, jab aap phone pe baat karte hain, there are a lot of thoughts that go into it which you can discuss. You can put your thoughts probably in a very, very simpler manner, but when it comes down to an email, it has to be framed correctly. Okay, the sequence has to be correct, you know, and putting everything in a proper manner can be very, very time taking. Okay, and especially if you are writing it to a client, to a senior person or something. So, you have to be very, very careful about drafting the email. So, it can at times be very, very draining for an employee, and they would land up spending more time writing an email than the actual work. Hacking bhi possible hota hai. Jab aap ek email bhejte hain from one server to the other server, okay, that fraction of a second. Okay, there are a lot of hackers nowadays. They can actually take away that email, or probably read that email, or stop that email in between. Okay, technology is beautiful, but technology is also many a times misused. So, hacking definitely possible. And during this particular time, a company ka confidential information, data, etc., can either be leaked or it can be, you know, lost for that matter. Misinterpretation, you meant something else, people understood something else. So, there is a clash of thoughts and perception. So, therefore, misinterpretation. Lack of privacy. So, when we talk about lack of privacy, it is more like aapko ek email aaya, you know, aap email padh rahe the, padhte padhte aap shayad utke chale gaye. So, what happens is somebody else is just passing by, reads the email. Okay, that's one. Second, galti se wo email forward ho jata hai. All right. These are things that, you know, when it is between two people, you know, or it's not that it is confidential, but it is only meant for a certain department, and the conversation is, of course, officially private. So therefore, it does not need to be marked to many people, or other people are not concerned about it. But then, of course, you do tend to lose your privacy out here, all right. And it is not just about official, at times it can even definitely go for personal, you know, when you have sent a personal email to somebody, that email can be very conveniently be forwarded to other people, and hence a lot of things can be misunderstood and misinterpreted, and for that matter even create tension and stress. The important points to remember out here are, while writing an email, the brands of the organization. Okay. When you are representing a company and you are writing an email on behalf of the company, okay, aap jis email ko jis tarike se aap draft karte hain, aap jis tarike se aap language use karte hain, ya aap usko format karte hain, it talks about your organization. Okay, it is an image of the organization that you are sending out at that point of time, because that person only knows you. Unke liye wo company aap ho. All right. So, you know, it is very, very important jab hum email, you know what we were talking about, that employee gets drained of a lot of energy. It is because of certain times like this. So, everybody does not have a knack of writing. But when it actually comes down to it, there could be a particular time that, you know, when a person needs to write an email to a client, but has to put in a lot of effort. But it is good that the person has, you know, is putting in that effort because he or she is representing the company. So, if you are unsure of what you are writing or whether you have written the right thing or not, always ensure that aap wo email apne senior ya colleague ya koi ek aapka reporting manager ho sakta hai, aap unse pehle ek bar aap proof read kara lijiye that kahin pe koi galti to nahi ho gayi, and then only send it out to the client. Otherwise, it can be a lot of damage. Okay, and next email would be damage control. The objective of email is usually to solve a problem, okay, or for that matter to convey a problem or an issue or concern also. On the other hand, it is also for instant gratification. Instant gratification ka matlab ho gaya that, you know, probably a team has done a good job or something. So, you do not mind, you know, the boss or the reporting manager would probably mark an email to everybody telling the entire organization that this department has done a wonderful job. So, it can be used for instant gratification with a logic, of course, and the reason and wrong, you know, warmth of the person. It feels very nice that, you know, not just the department, but the entire organization starts recognizing you, and that is only thanks to something as an email, you know, the accessibility of an email that instantly not only offices within a certain region, but if it is an MNC, probably everywhere around the world people get to know that you have done a good job, your team has done a good job. So, thanks to emails. We talk about, you know, certain anatomy of the email, in which to is one of the most important thing, okay. To is when you are addressing it to somebody, okay. But always remember, jab aap kisi ek particular insaan ko aap email mark kar rahe hain, there has, you know, it is only that person's email ID that should be there, okay. For example, if you are writing it to Madhu, why are these people here? These people, it was only for an information. So, information, you always put it here, alright. If there is a particular department, let us say aap HR department ko aap email maang karna chahte ho, department mein bahut saare log hain, you know, maybe the admin department or the finance department or something, then you should, you know, create a mailing list. Okay, so a mailing list is more like, you know, a grouping. Okay, aapne us group ke andar aapne sare jitne bhi HRs hai, aapne unke email IDs dale hai, and for that matter, and you know, us group ko aapne HR dala hai ya HR members dale hai. Okay, so maybe this is the main person, okay, that you are writing to, or ye sab ke sab jo hai aapke HR ke members hai. So, aapka group ka naam probably could be okay, और इसी के अंडर इन सब का ईमेल आईडी ऐड हो जाता है, पर आपके ईमेल में जब आप डालेंगे यहाँ सीसी में आपका सिर्फ इतना दिखेगा, दीज पीपल विल नॉट बी नोटिसेबल. ओके, सो वी कैन क्रिएट अ मेलिंग लिस्ट और वी कैन जस्ट पुट ऑल ऑफ देम, बट रिमेंबर वन थिंग दैट यू कैन नॉट बी राइटिंग वन ईमेल टू एवरीबडी. ओके, यू आर ओनली राइटिंग टू वन पर्सन. So, to be careful. CC. CC is a field where usually you are writing or you are marking, you are putting that email ID for a very simple reason, that you want to keep that person informed. Okay. Let us take an example ki admin ka ek particular department ka ek particular member hai jo aapke interaction mein hai for a certain project. Okay, आप उनको कोई information दे रहे हैं. Okay, so when you're giving that information to that person, you can't just give that person the information, you have to notify his boss also, you know, his reporting manager also. So in a scenario like that, you are going to mark the reporting manager in CC. Okay, and your conversation is actually with that person, okay, with the executive. Alright, but you are keeping the boss, the RM in CC to be informed of that particular event. Okay, and also remember that in CC field, it is not फॉर रिस्पॉन्स. रिस्पॉन्ड वही करता है जो टू में मार्क्ड होता है. ओके, जनरली दैट इज वेयर द एक्नॉलेजमेंट कम्स फ्रॉम. ओके, इन केस ऑफ अ सिचुएशन, जस्ट इन केस ऑफ अ सिचुएशन वेयर प्रोबेबली द मैनेजर यू नो हैज समथिंग टू से और मेंशन अबाउट इट और वुड लाइक टू गिव अ सजेशन ओवर इट, वो उस पर रिप्लाई करेगा. ओके, बट सीसी में जो मार्क्ड होते हैं इट इज नॉट देयर you know responsibility to acknowledge, or in fact they don't need to even acknowledge. It's an information which they have got. Okay, jab bhi aap cc mein koi email id dalte hain wo sabke sath share ho jata hai, sabko pata chal jata hai ki this person's email id is this, so that is a certain kind of an information that is going. Okay, bcc, blind carbon copy, this सेक्शन जनरली डज नॉट अपियर, तो आपको यू नो एडिशन डालना पड़ेगा दैट यू नो यू वॉन्ट टू बी सी सी इट टू समबडी. बट बी सी सी वाई इट इज़ यूज इज बिकॉज यू वॉन्ट टू मार्केट टू सर्टन पीपल. लेट्स टेक एन एग्जाम्पल, आपने किसी एग्जीक्यूटिव, आपके ऑफिस में बहुत बड़ा कोई इवेंट होने वाला है, या फॉर एग्जाम्पल आपके कॉलेज में बहुत बड़ा कोई इवेंट होने वाला है जो आप मैनेज कर रहे हो. सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम आप का यू नो प्रॉब्ली एच ओ डी इज शुड बी इन्फॉर्म्ड. ओके, कुछ आपके जो क्लासमेट्स हैं या कॉलीग्स हैं, फाइन, यू नो दे आर पार्टिसिपेटिंग और यू रिक्वायर द हेल्प, फाइन. सो यू हैव अ ब्लैंकेट अप्रूवल ऑफ एवरीथिंग. ब्लैंकेट अप्रूवल एज इन यू हैव बीन गिवन अ फ्री हैंड टू डू दैट जॉब एंड यू नो टू टेक हेल्प वेर एवर रिक्वायर्ड, बट you still have to keep people informed because they might not be at work, they might not be in class, or you know you need a special notification for it. So in this particular reason what you would be doing is you would be writing to the group of students or the group of colleague. All right, that's one. In two, you would be marking a cc to the HOD or to the reporting manager, unke reporting managers. Okay, and the BCC probably can go to the vice president or let's say to the director of your college or let's say to you know the chairman or you know the top management that is there, so that they are also aware of the event that you are doing and what all you are doing, right? But those people are going to be in BCC because aap unko you know those executives, those team members, or for that matter you know those colleagues or your classmates, आप उनके साथ आपके top management का जो email ID है वो आप share नहीं कर सकते हो. Okay, because it is not you know it's not supposed to be accessible for everyone unless they themselves give it. Okay, so in that particular scene, the you know what is going to happen is your email addresses are protected. ओके, बिकॉज वो दिखेगा नहीं, फाइन, यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू सी. अगर आपने ईमेल किया है बीसीसी मार्क करके किसी को, वो रेसिपिएंट को नहीं पता चलेगा कि क्या आपने ये ईमेल आपने किसी और को भी भेजा है क्योंकि वो बीसीसी में था. ऑलराइट, बट एज अ प्रोटोकॉल यू विल ऑलवेज इंक्लूड द नेम ऑफ द पीपल, दैट इज टूवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ द ईमेल आप उसमें लिखेंगे कॉपीड टू एंड यू आर गोइंग टू राइट द नेम्स ऑफ द पीपल और द डेजिग्नेशन ऑफ द पीपल जिसको आपने ये ईमेल कॉपी किया है. ओके, सो ऑलवेज रिमेंबर व्हाट आर द थिंग्स टू, एंड गोइंग बैक टू टू फॉर दैट मैटर, इफ यू आर राइटिंग टू अ ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल, ऑलराइट, मे बी एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम येस यू कैन पुट दोज कपल ऑफ पीपल, बट यू विल हैव टू एड्रेस देम इन दैट एज वेल. ऑलराइट, ईमेल इज अ रिटन, यू नो इट्स अ it's something that is like a document. Okay, it's it has no face. Okay, it has no body language, it has no eye contact. Okay, it has no contact as such, no physical appearance, nothing that you can see. Okay, so that is the reason why in cheezon ko compensate karne ke liye we are going to talk about the basic five fundamental rules of email writing, which is going to compensate for all this, where all the smiles etc is going to be taken care of, and the warmth and the intention and the ideas are going to be put across. The first rule, your subject line. कितना इम्पोर्टेंट है, वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट, एक्सट्रीमली इम्पॉर्टेंट इन फैक्ट. अगर आपका सब्जेक्ट लाइन अगर पिन पॉइंट नहीं करेगा कि आपका ईमेल किसके बारे में है, मोस्ट प्रोबेबल फैक्ट आपका ईमेल कोई पढ़ेगा ही नहीं, ओके, और फॉर दैट मैटर इग्नोर कर देंगे, और इवन फॉर दैट मैटर हो सकता है कि यू नो दे विल से ओके नॉट वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट सो वील रीड इट लेटर, ओके. सो चूजिंग योर सब्जेक्ट लाइन extremely important, okay. So when the person is going to be able to understand कि आपने वो email क्यों भेजा है, that is when they will probably respond to it on time or appropriately, I should say, okay. Subject line छोटा होना चाहिए, not more than 5 to 7 words, okay. And usually जब एक conversation होता है, you know, you see this re appearing too many times, okay. So जब ये re ज़्यादा appear करता है, try and delete it, okay, because it will just keep on repeating re, okay. So that subject line is going to become a little too long, so just try and delete a section of it so that you know the subject line does not look too bad, okay. And also at times we might even have to change the subject line. Aapne ek email likha hai project ke bare mein to give an idea of a new project jo you know aapko responsibility di gayi hai, but however us email mein project ke bare mein aapka first email jo hai wo project ke bare mein tha, but aapke paas ek question aaya on the budget, okay. So now the discussion is not just the project and the idea, but it is about the budget, okay. So aapka next one or two emails probably budget ke upar hoga as a revert, probably aapka senior manager jo hai aapko revert karta hai aapke project email ke upar ki okay can you please share the details of the budget that you have decided for this project, okay. The trail mail is important, okay, because it is about the same project. However, instead of talking about the ideas, we are talking about the budget now. So to ensure that you know your focus is correct on you know and you have the attention of everybody correctly, you are going to change the subject line for that same email. All right. So probably you know aapka shayad subject line might have been something like summary of the project, okay, probably the name of the project you can put. Fine. And however during the course of the conversation you can probably put name of the project and you can say budget of this particular project, okay. So then you know it will be bang on and people are going to be able to understand that okay ye summary tha, ye project ke bare mein tha, uske baad hum log budget ke bare mein baat kar rahe hain, okay. So people will be more focused and will know exactly what is happening in the discussion of the email. Effective and non-effective, okay. December sales, okay. December sales figure, so what do I do about it? Subject line ko padh ke mujhe ye nahi samajh mein aayega ki December sales figure aapko chahiye, aap mujhe bata rahe ho, aap mujhse pooch rahe ho, ya aap forecast kar rahe ho, aap kya kar rahe ho, okay. But when I write something send figures for December sales, okay, I have work, I understand it now that what exactly is expected out of it. So I'm going to quickly read the email and reply to it, okay. So similarly when you're talking about something like a status report doesn't say anything, kis cheez ka status, kaun sa report, okay. Maine kuch status report manga nahi tha, but if I'm going to probably talk about this, mera ek particular project chal raha hai, but mujhe problem aa rahi hai warehouse you know restoration phase mein hai, but वो कब होगा, जो हमें टाइमलाइन दिया गया था वो सही जा रहा है कि नहीं, कैन आई यू नो प्लान माय प्रोजेक्ट एंड माय वर्क अकॉर्डिंगली. सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर केस इफ आई एम सेंडिंग आउट एन ईमेल लेट्स से टू एडमिन, ओके, देन इन दैट केस प्रोबेबली माय सब्जेक्ट लाइन वुड बी दैट वेयरहाउस रिस्टोरेशन इज इन स्केड्यूल, ओके, और मे बी द एडमिन इज सेंडिंग इट आउट टू एवरीबडी दैट the warehouse restoration isn't scheduled. So everybody can plan their work accordingly. Everything, you know, or ya to agar deadline agar upar niche karna hai or something, it can be worked around it because I know ki ye schedule pe hai ya schedule pe nahi hai. Fine. So this becomes a more appropriate subject line for that email or information. The second rule, greeting. Greeting is like jab hum kisi se milte hain, hum namaste karte hain, hum hi karte hain, hello karte hain, good morning karte hain, good afternoon, good evening, ye sab kuch karte hain. Similarly, email mein greeting is extremely important. Okay, you can always ask, you know, greet, you can always mention greetings of the day, or I hope it's, you know, I hope you're keeping well, agar for that matter the person was unwell, or you can even mention that it was a pleasure meeting you yesterday, okay, or it was a pleasure speaking to you yesterday, okay, creating some kind of a, you know, first bracket of your conversation before you start with the real agenda of the email, okay. So please do that. Also notice how your contact signs off, how does your contact like to be referred to, that is part of your email, okay, agar aap, you know, a part of your greeting in the email. So in case if you miss it, that, you know, you don't mention your highs and your hellos and your name, etc., okay, you can be actually be perceived as you're very bossy, okay, because you're, or you know, a person with no etiquette for that matter. So please do mention it. We are going to be talking about the greeting, wherein we are talking about why it is important. Socially it is better, it develops a rapport, it can you know, create that kind of familiarity of things, okay. And when we had mentioned about know how the person signs off, okay, whether that person uses Vikas Khanna, or whether that person just says Khanna, or whether that person says V Khanna, okay, notice how that person signs off his emails, all right. And similarly, for formal greetings, we are always going to use a Mr. according to how that person signs, all right. And informal, we can just mention the first name. And a casual example just can be a Vikas Khanna, or even for that matter, even only Vikas can work out here, okay. But this is of utmost importance, okay. Mr. Vikas Khanna, Mr. V Khanna, Mr. Khanna, okay. And it do always mention the name, because what happens is that at times it is important for them to understand that this email is specified for them. Most you know, of the organizations, before they start getting familiar with you, they would give you a generic email ID. Let's take an example like info@, connect@, or sales@, okay. So there are many people out there. So when you're going to be mentioning the name, okay, jab aap specifically naam likhoge, so they will know, whoever is monitoring the email, okay, will know for sure that this person, you know, this email is for this particular person. So it will be forwarded to that person and not just be lost, okay, ki it is just a sir and a ma'am, to koi bhi ho sakta, alright. So mentioning the name and in the correct way is definitely going to get your email across to the right person. The body of the email, please ensure your grammar and punctuation is in place, okay. Please ensure that your you know, the case, that is, you know, the capital and the small is in place also, because agar aap sirf small mein likhoge, they probably feel that, okay, too lazy, you know, or probably is a little too tied up, or probably is not interested, okay. So try and make sure that your cases are put in the right place. Review and spell check, okay, and avoid anything in red. Red is not a very nice thing to see in an email, because it's more like warning or alert or something. So try and avoid red in any of your emails. Punctuation. Let's eat, mother. Let's eat mother, a small little comma out here made a difference. So, this is the kind of difference that is going to make whenever you are writing an email. Okay. So, that is the reason why we say do not forget your punctuations. Okay. Let's take an example. This particular example, the name is starting with a small letter. Okay. There are hardly any punctuation, you don't see any full stop out here except in the end, all right. Short forms, all right. Don't, it does not have apostrophe, okay. Again, there is another short form, does not look like a very nice and appealing email. However, if we just change it a little bit, in capital, you have your punctuations, which adds more meaning to the sentence, and the sentences are short, okay, and the email is to the point and it is easy to understand, all right. The fourth rule, choice of words, especially when you are closing. You could probably have complained about something, you could have shared a problem, you could have shared a concern, or you could have probably not been, it is not a very pleasant email, but on the other hand, thank you for your time. Why? You are already thanking that person for taking out the time to read the email, you know, to understand, you know, the kind of issues that you are facing. Or for that matter, you know, the time that they have taken to read your report and revert. Okay. So, sincerely looking forward is when you are trying to create an association further, okay, or just regards, signing off on anything, or looking forward to associating with you further, looking forward to your call, if a call is what is expected out of that email, or for that matter, even a revert, a suggestion, and advice on any one of the matter. So, do sign it off in that manner. Signature, yes, just like the way it is important for you to address the person by their name, it is extremely important for you to mention your name. Okay, always write, mention who wrote the email. Okay, it should never be left blank, not with just a regards and there is no name. Okay. It was sent to somebody, it was sent by somebody. So, those two names are extremely important. Okay. Whenever you are signing off your name, please sign it off properly. Write your full name. Okay. Avoid all small, just the first name, just the initial, or no name at all. All right. This is a complete no-no, this is definitely a yes, all right. So, anything that follows up out here. Rule number 5, your attachments. We are sending out a report, we write the email, we write such an intense email and we forget to put the attachment and we send it, okay, or for that matter we even send the wrong attachment. Okay. So, please avoid that, please avoid recalling or checking or getting a reminder for it, all right. Check your attachment is added. If you think you have a, you know, it usually happens that, you know, you forget the attachment, attach your emails, the data or the document first, okay, and then you can write your email so that you don't miss it up. And the second thing that I feel that you should do is that after attaching your document, okay, click on the document separately from the email, from the attachment, and check if you have sent the right attachment or you have attached the right document, okay. That is going to be a double check, especially when you are sending an email to your senior, you know, or to a client or something, this is a no error zone. Fine. So, please ensure that you do this double check before you send out any emails. Also, of course, in the previous slide I had mentioned, you know, out here that it would be nice if you mentioned that it is a Word document or any other kind of a format, because quite possible that the person might not have access to it. So, mentioning it, it would be great that in case if they are not able to access it, they can email back to you immediately mentioning that they cannot access this kind of format and to share some other format with you. The most important, right from now and going forward, we have to start getting used to having a professional email ID. Professional email ID, because it can be for anybody actually, within you know, your college, whether you're writing to your teacher, your professor, your colleagues, you know, probably when you start for your internship, probably when you're going to be applying for an internship, or you could be emailing to the bosses, etc. Initially, at times, maybe for a couple of days, you might have to use your own email, personal email ID, till the time your official email ID is created when you join. An email like ID like this is not going to be acceptable, and it is not going to look nice. Even if you're going to write an email ID like this for, you know, while applying for a job on your resume, it is quite a put off. Okay, people are not going to look at it, or they just might brush it aside, saying that I think this person is still a little too immature. Okay, so probably we'll look at it later. All right. So try, if you do have any of these kind of email IDs, maybe you can continue using it, but for a different section of people. But on the other hand, please try and come up with something more professional. So let's take an example. You can use something like common names. You will have a little bit of a trouble, but you can try and do something like this. Like out here, I have tried putting an extra S, I have put a dot, I have put numericals. Probably I can put one more dot out here, or probably I can even you know, put the initial of my surname, you know, which is going to make it a little more unique. You will have to do a little bit of a permutation combination of thing and find the right email ID for you. But yes, please do add your name so that it is easier for people to understand who the email is going to and gives a good impression about you as well. So, I hope this session has helped you to understand the basics of writing an email, and you know, in the further sessions we talk about the email writing, and I hope that is going to be equally helpful to you. In case of any more questions, anything that you would like more clarity on, please feel free to comment. Thank you very much.